Trump supporter admits that he committed a lot of crimes and made it look like Antifa did it. Black Lives Matter, Joe Biden supporters. Let's put up some of the damage he did to his own home. You see that? He claimed initially that this was done to him. A Minnesota Trumper, who officials say staged a fire and blamed it on left-wing radicals, pleaded guilty to wire fraud. Denis Molla, let's put his picture up. Oh, Denis, we've covered him before. A Brooklyn center has been charged with two counts of wire fraud over the September 2020 arson incident, where he had claimed to be the victim of a politically motivated attack. Look at him. Him just a victim. That's all. This person submitted over $3,000 in bogus insurance claims and received around $61,000 from his insurance company. He even received $17,000 in GoFundMe donations to support for what he called a hate crime had been committed against him. At the time, he had told NBC affiliate KARE 11, he had chased three individuals out of his yard that night, saying one of them dropped a box of matches. Now let me say this, put up the house again. The people at the NBC affiliate, y'all should have known good and damn well he was lying. He then says when he returned home, he found his vehicles and garage being engulfed by these flames. A spray painted message or messages that said Biden 2020, BLM for Black Lives Matter, and a symbol believed to be associated with Antifa was scrawled across his garage door. His was insane about his plan. People, first of all, Black Lives Matter they've never said, oh, and vote for Biden. That has never been their political ideology. Black Lives Matter, you must vote for Joe Biden. They've challenged Joe Biden. So please tell me that the investigators caught on to this based on the mess that he painted. Why is it that the reporters did not catch on to this? Wait a minute, Biden and Black Lives Matter and the Antifa symbol? Come on. This cat even claimed that he rescued four sleeping puppies from inside the garage. Put his picture up again. So let me get this right. People came to your house, you Billy Badass, you chased them away. As you chased them away, they dropped matches that you saw. Obviously, they dropped because who would know that detail unless they saw it. You come back to your house is just magically engulfed in flames because all this happened when you were not there. And then you also saved the dogs. They believed this mess at first. The GoFundMe speculated that because Denis installed a Trump 2020 flag on his truck and due to the spray paint left on his garage door, it's believed he was targeted for his patriotic support of our president. Let's put up the truck. He says, that's why this happened to me. Investigators concluded otherwise and determined that Mr. Molla staged the whole thing. In reality, as Molla well knew, he started the fire at his own property. He spray painted the graffiti on his own property, and there were no unknown males near his home. Charging documents say, according to the Star Tribune. What about the money and the jail time? The attorney for this guy says the defendant paid back all of the insurance money he collected and has saved up enough to pay back the GoFundMe donations as soon as the court facilitates it. The plea deal did not nail down prison time precisely. So when this guy is sentenced in a future date, he will likely face 3 to 4 years in prison based on normative sentencing standards. But the judge has the discretion to give less. Wanted to give you an update of this. But once again, why did he do it this way? He did it this way because he's exploiting the reality that Trump supporters will basically believe anything you tell them as long as you say a black person did it or a Democrat did it. And then the trifecta, black, Democrat, and down with Antifa. This is the atmosphere we're in. It produces elements like this. He should be held completely accountable for the crimes he committed and the exploitation he attempted. Taking advantage of real racial issues happening in this country, not providing a remedy, not providing a solution, but only trying to make his pockets fat. Jeff, thoughts here?
When I first heard of this story, I immediately thought of the Blacks Rule story from a couple of years ago. The viewers need to go and Google Blacks Rule and see what comes up with that. It's the exact same situation. You know, my black spider senses started to tingle when I saw that Biden 2020 thing. Yeah. As a Biden voter, I know daggone well we're not repping him like that. I mean, no offense to him, but he wasn't all of our first priority, our first choice when it came to the president.
Right.
So we're not repping that. I'm from an era where if we were going to graffiti something, we would put our neighborhood up. I mean, probably not now because I just said it. But for me, it was Agla Green. Dr. Richey, I know for you, it was Glenwood. But you know, that's not really the thing anymore. Hey, you know what? So there was a part of this that made me mad, and you alluded to it earlier when he said that when he got back to the burning garage, there were four puppies in there. Hey, dog. You're already trying to blame black people for some stuff that they didn't do. Don't bring puppies into this. You know white people love dogs. How dare you? I'm offended.
He played into all of it. He's a hero. He's a badass. He's a victim.
Checklist.
He cares for the dogs. Mm-hmm.
He must have went to some like website that like every buzzword you could think of, he's like, okay, I need to include all these and the puppies just in case. Because the victim mentality told him that because he's a Trump supporter, this was going to happen to him. But
yeah, I think he was freestyling the puppy part.
Yeah, I don't think that was on the checklist.
Right.
Yeah.
Blew the whole case wide open. I don't know.